show?
We are good for show, thank you.
Lighting, are you good for show?
Yeah, lighting good for show, thanks Jim.
Audio, are you good for show?
Audio's good.
Stand by everybody. Go with house lights. And go show.
This is iHeartRadio Live with Queen and Adam Lambert from the iHeartRadio Theater in Los Angeles. Here's your host, Nikki Sixx.
Hey, it's Nikki Sixx. Welcome to an exclusive iHeartRadio Live. They rocked the iHeartRadio Music Festival. Tonight, you're going to get exclusive performances and interviews from Queen and Adam Lambert.
This is such a treat, and it's not every day you get to see Queen perform. And sometimes I find myself on stage, like, watching them, like, I'm a fan, like, oh my God, like, I forget, oh yeah, I'm supposed to be singing. Like, I'm watching Roger and Brian, like, just kill it. And I was drawn to Queen and Freddie because of his theatricality. It felt, like, familiar to me in a way. It was kind of marrying the best of both worlds, theater and rock and roll.
Hey guys, great to be here with you. Queen, Adam Lambert. So Brian, you've hinted at possibly maybe this might be your last, you know, go around.
I kind of said that whimsically and it was picked up by the Brits. I said, like, you know, one more time around, what harm can it do, you know? But I mean, there's no reason to say this is the end. I mean, I feel very fortunate to be able to do it at all. You know, I really, you know, a lot of times in the past few years, I thought, well, that's done. You know, we did that and that was great. I had no real thought of doing it again. You know, the fact that we can do it and do it on this scale and at this level of professionalism, the team is incredible here, you know, is great. You know, so I'm just grateful we can do it. And if we can do it again one day, who knows?
Yeah, you know? What happens, happens.
We didn't really look for Adam. He just kind of turned up and there he was. And
on
we
your
thought,
front stoop.
Oh, that would be good. Yeah, and there he was, you know, and he's stupendous, you know, so suddenly it becomes all worthwhile again. And here we jump in the big time again. It's great.
Yeah, there was no big plan really. We heard about Adam and then by pure chance we found ourselves playing on the Idol final. And there he was, and so we got to know him and played with him, and it just sort of went on. It was a natural thing from there. His voice is so incredible.
When you did American Idol, you know, choosing Bohemian Rhapsody, I mean, you'd never have made contact at this point.
No.
It is interesting how that changed history. There was a moment somewhere in your life where you said, I'm going to do this song.
Yeah.
And these men who you've never met with this legacy is going to see that. And you guys are going to be sitting here today and then taking off and doing a tour.
Yeah, if someone had told me then, like, by the way, fast forward to 5 years from now, I wouldn't have believed them, you know? Yeah.
There is a thrill for us. I mean, because you've been kind of continuous in a way, but for us it was all over when Freddie went,
sure.
You know? And I never thought we'd be doing, like, the Forum, Madison Square Garden again. I really didn't think that was going to happen, and it's going to happen in the next couple
exciting,
of months. It's incredible. Amazing.
It's such a part of your life.
Yeah, with a whole new audience and some of the old guys, hopefully, you know, but, you know, a new opportunity.
So you guys blew everybody away at the iHeartRadio Music Festival. Was that testing the waters for the future?
Well, in a way, I mean, it's the same thing as we were saying. It was just a moment, which we enjoyed, really. But I have to say that that appearance had a big, big part of selling this tour out, I'm sure, you know. We do Twitter and stuff, don't we? We tweet and stuff, you know. You see this kind of the feedback, and people saw it, and they saw him sing, like, Who Wants to Live Forever, and were blown away, you know. So that generated some of the excitement which made us able to do this tour. So we owe iHeart a lot, really.
And it was cool, too, to see an American audience that was so diverse because it was a festival. You know, it wasn't just Queen fans. You had pop fans, and everyone really responded to it, no matter what their genre that they liked was. And I thought that was really good to see, you know, about how Queen's music kind of reaches a lot of different types of people. That's really exciting to see that. Who wants to
Okay, so the tour starts Thursday in Chicago. What can fans expect?
Oh, what can they expect? Well, it's extravagant and it's no holds barred, really. And we've worked really hard on the music. And it's a show, you know, it's an entertainment. It's kind of a circus, isn't it, really?
It's very, quite an organic sort of set. I mean, we don't have any clicks. All the singing is real.
It's real.
But it's all real. Everything you hear is real. Which is quite unusual, I think, these days. So it's quite dangerous for us.
Live and dangerous.
We're taking a risk every night.
Yeah, which is what it is about, really. And we know we can do it. We know he can do it as well, which is really good. Yeah.
You know, we've done this a handful of times now, and I think it's getting more and more comfortable and more of a kind of a gelled thing, but I definitely am in awe of the history and the legacy of this band. I mean, this is like rock royalty. They've really like kind of carved out their own corner of classic rock and have created songs that have been a part of everybody's lives for so long that are so iconic. And so kind of stepping into the situation, especially at first, was pretty daunting.
With Adam, things are different, you know, and I look forward to the different interpretations. One of the things he does great is The Show Must Go On, which we never, which we recorded with Freddie, but we never performed with him because he was gone. Mm-hmm. And to hear Adam do that is stupendous. And I get kind of chills up the spine every time, you know, and I have to kind of keep concentrating. That's something which has become stupendous in my mind.
Except for yesterday when I forgot the words during
rehearsal.
It was
really
that was awful.
Yeah.
Music has continued to sell and stay in the mainstream. My kids are anywhere from 13 to 20. They know the catalog. You know, fans out there, original fans, have kids that know the catalog. So, you know, it's important to take it out and let them see it live. You know, they might have missed that. And you get great with Adam and you guys, and it's going to be a fantastic tour.
We're doing quite a few old songs. From the early days when we were more of a heavy rock band, really, you know. Well, we were quite heavy in those days, and I've forgotten there's a...
It's very raw, and it definitely has that vintage 70s over-the-top flamboyant thing.
There's a lot of incandescence. There's not a lot of LEDs and stuff. It's very kind of... It's the old technology, but in a new way, I guess.
No expense spared.
With some very new technology to complement it, I must say. Yeah.
Everything is gold.
A lot of gold.
Yeah, a lot of gold.
Yeah, should we tell them that story? I saw the sketches, and we were all having meetings back and forth on Skype about different elements, and a couple days later, I woke up from a dream, and I was like, I think it needs to be gold. I think there needs to be more gold. I mean, so I wrote them an email. I said, guys, what if instead of everything being kind of that, you know, iron, industrial, gunmetal color, like, what if it was gold? They were back then, gold, huh? And I said, yeah, gold.
I liked it.
Yeah, okay.
So everything,
there it is,
gold.
There it is.
Kind of that old, like, Chevy kind of car 70s gold, you know? Now get on your bikes and
roll! I mean, I gotta say, Adam is amazing. Nothing is ever too much trouble for him. He doesn't go, oh, God, I don't know. He goes, oh, yeah, okay, I could, I can work on that.
No, you know, diva?
He has a great confidence, but he also has a kind of a sort of reality, a sort of humility, and likes to work. You know, like us. You know, we like a challenge. So
I heard the word diva.
Oh no!
Yeah, that's what we do.
That's what we do.
I think that's the character that is in a lot of the songs. I think that's what Freddie did so beautifully. Is that it's a character. It's insinuated in some of the music as this kind of over the top flamboyant.
Yeah.
But I don't know if that's necessarily really what happens in the heart. It's more of this peacocking that happens, which is...
That's what you want from performers.
It's rock and roll, isn't it? I mean,
isn't
that the
idea? You don't want to go watch a band stare at their shoes.
No.
You want to be entertained.
Yeah.
Yeah, no shoe gazing.
Yeah.
No.
And I think that there's a humor in it. Being ridiculous and being... That whole rock and roll spirit is something that I'm still totally in love with.
You need to be ridiculous, and you need to be able to look back 5, 10, 15 years and go, what the hell was I wearing?
I look back like yesterday and go, what the
hell
was
I doing
yesterday?
Last? What was that?
What was that?
Well, Well, now the band that needs no further introduction, live from the iHeart Radio Theater in Los Angeles, Queen and Adam Lambert.
Funky. Spot, how long can you stand the heat? another one bites the dust. Hey! There are plenty of ways you can hurt a man and bring him to the ground. You can beat him, you can cheat him, you can treat him bad and leave him while he's got it. But I'm ready, yes I'm ready for you. I'm a hanging on my own two feet. Out of the doorway, the bullets rip through the side of the field. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Another one, hey, hey, yeah. Another one.
Crazy. That's right. Yeah, let's get a little cray cray.
Listen, I call them. I can't handle it. Listen, call them.
Little thing on earth. Hey! Take it away!
Pena, stools. It's time for the stools. We've talked a lot about the stool moment. So comfortable, right? Stool moment. So we have a little bit of a little treat in this set that we're going to be doing this summer on tour. There is what kind of is considered a new song that many people might not have heard before in the context of Queen. Freddie Mercury worked on a song. Freddie Mercury! He created a song with Giorgio Moroder for the film Metropolis. It's called Love Kills. And we're gonna do it for you in our own way, minus the disco.
Yeah. Hey. Love don't pay no bills, and love don't give no indication. Love just don't stand still. Love kills, drills you through your heart. Love kills, scars you from the start. It's just a take no reservations. Love is no scared deal. And love don't give no justification. It strikes like cold steel. Love kills, drills you through your heart. Love kills, scars you from the start. It's just to your heart.
bitches out there.
Tonight, oh, down beside that red firelight, oh.
I don't know if it's PC for iHeartRadio to update it to fat ass bitches. Is there kids in here? Sorry, kids, sorry. Brats. Fat bottomed brats. Yeah. Rock and roll.
Champions, my friends, and we'll
couldn't call. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. We are the champions.
You guys want to hear one more? Yeah? You want to hear one more? Because we can't just stop now. That was the cue. That was it. We can't just stop now. So corny, isn't it? That was so awful. So, don't stop us now. Oh, we're still waiting on keys. Are we good? Do we have a piano? All right, that's me. That's me. Okay. I can't hear a fucking thing, so, you know. Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world is turning inside out, yeah. So don't stop me now. Don't stop me, cause I'm having a good time. Having a good time. I'm a shooting star racing through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, go, go. There's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky. Yeah, 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna be a supersonic man out of you. Don't stop me now. I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball. Don't stop me now. If you wanna have a good time,
Nikki Six, this is Jen. We're from Sixth Sense. I don't know about you, but I could have heard maybe 25 more songs. What do you think?
Yeah. That was incredible. Adam killed it on the vocals. It was insane. You could feel it in this room.
What do you think?
Yeah.
Listen, I was 14 years old. I lived in Seattle. Queen played at the Paramount Theater. I slept on the sidewalk outside to see these guys. Blew my mind. So to sit up here and get to interview them was such an honor for me after so many years of being a fan.
Were you nervous at all when you sat in front of them? Did you like shake a little?
You know, the thing about these guys is their music is so powerful and it's so iconic, but they're nice people. You can see it, right? You can see that they're humble people.
Funny. They're very funny.
They're very funny. Very proper British. So they're going to be going out on tour, and we're really excited, right? I mean, come on.
Yeah. Is that a show that you would like to see?
It's a show I'd like to see, but I'm not going to sleep on the sidewalk for
you're
this
not,
one.
You're not? I think you should do it for old time's sake.
Just for oh, want to do it with me, we'll sleep outside.
It'd be a good time.
Yeah.
I wonder if Adam like just looks in the mirror and he goes, "Damn, I look good." You know, because he's that guy to me.
I was
he's
thinking
so
that.
Good looking. Right? Right?
Yeah, he is. All well, right. we're having a little bit of a shoe competition, and a close competition when I interviewed them, and he pretty much kicked my ass.
I think that they might have gotten some pointers from you, though, on this next tour. I saw some things outside with spikes and glitter. I'm waiting for the blood and the flame shooting bass.
With Queen.
Yeah, I think they're gonna take a couple pointers from
so
you.
So let's see, what are these guys doing? They're starting the tour in Chicago with Adam. 19 cities to start off with.
That's awesome.
That's not awesome.
No, it is awesome.
No, 19 cities is not awesome. We need 70. They need to go around the world. They need to go to South America. They need to go to Japan. And then they got to come back to America. What do you think? Right now, they're backstage going, oh, Jesus.
Right. Thanks a lot, Nikki. Hey, guys, thanks for coming out tonight. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. It's been amazing. I can still feel it. I'm shaking. I still feel the energy.
And
I love
thanks
it.
Thanks to iHeartRadio Live for having us host this wonderful night. And you guys have a kick-ass night, all right? Go home and listen to some Queen.